If you just finished your Calculus 2 class and you think you know all the integrals, then this video is for you because I will go over two very challenging integrals in an unfair way, I would say. The first one here is actually from the MIT Integration B. So go ahead and pause the video and try this first. You did? Okay, cool. Wow. Shall we just do partial fractions? Integration by parts? Will maybe tricks up? I don't think so, unless you can actually make it work, and in that case, let me know. Fundamentally, we love to use u-substitution. That's the most fundamental integration technique. But if you let u equal to this, it's not going to work, all right? So how can we do this? After seeing the solution, this is how, right? I didn't figure this out, just to be honest with you guys. Take a look right here. We are actually going to factor this out. In this way, factor out x to the fourth power, and then we will get 1 plus x to the negative 4. This is okay, all right? And then you see that this is what we have, but don't forget we still have the fourth root, and then we also have this parentheses raised to the third power. Well, we can actually break this apart now. Here we will get the integral, and then we have the 1 over x squared is still in the front, but when we have x to the fourth power instead of the fourth root, that's just x to the first power. Of course, we're not talking about like to put the absolute value, don't worry about that too much. But don't forget we still have the third power. So altogether, this and that will give us x to the third power. Alright? And then I will still keep this instead of the radical. So here we have the fourth root of parentheses 1 plus x to the negative 4, and then to the third power, and then dx. Very good. Have a look. This time, we have, what? 1 plus x to the negative 4. If we differentiate this, the function part is x to the negative 5. Do we have x to the negative 5? We do. It's right here. X squared times x to the third power, of course, is x to the fifth, but we can just put that up here and make that into a negative exponent. So we are going to look at this as the integral, and this is on the top now, x to the negative 5 over, I'm going to write the radical as a rational exponent. So we have parentheses, and then we have the 3 over 4th power, and then the inside is 1 plus x to the negative 4, and then we have the dx. And now what can we do? U substitution. So here, let's go ahead and do that. Let u equal the inside, so I will just put it down here. We have 1 plus x to the negative 4, and then we see that du is just going to be negative 4 x to the negative 5, and then dx. And we can isolate the dx. Dx is just equal to, divide this on both sides, we get du over negative 4 x to the negative 5. I know that's an integral sign, but maybe another bigger integral. No, this is not integral sign. But anyway, this right here is going to be the integral. Let me just write this down again. X to the negative 5 over the inside here is the u. And then we have this raised to the 3 over 4th power. And then the dx is that. This du over negative 4 x to the negative 5. And ladies and gentlemen, this and that cancel out nicely. So we can finish this, right? We have the 1 over negative 4, just put that in the front. And then we just have to integrate. This is the same as u to the negative 3 over 4th power, and we are in the u world. So to finish this, let's just go ahead and add 1 to the power, which is going to be positive 1 over 4, and divided by the new power, which is the same as multiplied by 4 over 1. Have a look. They cancel. Very nice, huh? So we have the answer. Negative u to the 1 over 4th power, which is the same as the 4th root of, and then the inside is just the u, and u is just that. So I'll just put down 1 plus x to the negative 4. And then we are done. So put down the plus c. Wow, this is it. So this is almost like a brain teaser, I would say. Yeah. But really, really fun. And you think this is it? No, I have another one, as I told you, so let's check out the other one. Okay, for the second integral here, I got this from the book called the Putnam and Beyond. So if you like challenging math questions, definitely check this out. All right. Shall we do the thing that we did earlier? Maybe factor out x plus third power from the inside and then put it on the outside? No, because if you do that, we don't have negative exponent anymore unless you put it on the bottom part. That's not going to help. Again, after seeing the solution, I figured out how to do it. Well, it doesn't make sense for me to say I see the solution and figure out. No. Yeah, I had to see the solution for this one. You see, we have x plus 6 power, and then this is x plus 3 power. We can factor it out. But do not factor out x plus 3 power. Rather, we are going to factor out just x to the first power. So, have a look. This is the integral, and we will have x to the fifth plus x squared. And again, we factor out the x, so I'll put it here. And then we have the cube root of x to the third power plus 2, and then here's the dx. Why do we want to do that? Well, this is kind of like the opposite of what we did earlier. We are going to put the x inside here. Yeah. And here we have x to the first power on the outside, but once we distribute it, because it's the cube root, this is actually x to the third power inside. So all in all, this is going to give us the integral x to the fifth power plus x squared, and then we have the cube root x to the third power times x to the third power, that will give us x to the sixth power, and then plus 2x to the third power. Yep, and now, what's this? Can we do something about it? Yes, what can we do? Yes, u-substitution once again. Let's go ahead and put u to be the inside, which is x to the sixth power plus 2x to the third power, and then du is just 6x to the fifth power plus 6x squared, parentheses, and then the dx. Divide this on both sides, and let's also factor out the 6, because you see, this doesn't have the 6, but both of them have the 6. Dx equals du over that, but factor out just the 6, and we will have x to the 5th plus x squared. And as always, take this integral to the u world, which is a much better place for the integrals to be at, right? Here we have the integral, parentheses, x to the 5th plus x squared. And again, let's write the cube root as the 1/3 power. Here inside is just the u, and then here we have the 1/3 power. Dx is that, which is du over 6 parentheses x to the 5th plus x squared, and then, cancel. So, we just have to put the 1 over 6 all the way in the front first, and then integrate u to the 1/3 power in the u world. And now we just have to do the reverse power rule. Add 1 to this, which is going to be 4 over 3, and then divide it by the new power, which is the multiply by the reciprocal, which is 3 over 4. All right, reduce this, we get a 2, and then we have the 1 over 8. And then this is, I think I'm just going to write it as, well, we start with radical form, I want to end up with radical form too. So for the little 3, that's the radical. And then we have the u, which is that. So we have x to the 6th power plus 2x to the 3rd power. But don't forget, we still have this to the 4th power. Yeah, like this. Cool, huh? Plus c. Wow. As I said, this is almost like a brain teaser in a really, really fun way, though. I love it. Yeah. Most likely, like for you guys, and also for me, that I have not seen this question before, you know, like this kind of approach before. So once you see it, just kind of keep that in mind. So later on, if you have an integral that's attacking you, maybe you can use a similar technique to, you know, fight back. Yeah, so if you want to see more integration videos, check out my other videos, and I'll see you guys over there. That's it.